Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. As you can see on the SSGI graph, we had strong seismic activity, a typical clustering following planetary conjunctions on the 7th and on the 9th. With a threshold of magnitude 5.6 and larger, we see also a magnitude 6.2 earthquake, the first magnitude 6 earthquake since May 31st. And this happened yesterday morning in Japan, the Hokkaido, Japan region. In the previous update, I explained the convergence of conjunctions tomorrow on the 13th. Here we see the high red peak and a purple peak following that peak, that red peak. And first we have Sun, Mercury and Neptune in a conjunction. That will be tomorrow morning. And that's going to be a critical one. And it will be followed by Venus, Mercury and Jupiter later on the same day. And that combination is going to be critical. And in a worst case scenario, we could see a major seismic event in the days following that convergence. But that very much depends on the condition of Earth's crust, whether or not a larger fault section has reached critical stress. In the solar system, we see this critical geometry marked by the red lines, Sun, Mercury, Neptune, and also Venus, Mercury, Jupiter. They basically occur at the same time. There are only several hours in between. I also would like to pay attention to the lunar geometry involving Mars and Saturn. That is going to play a major role in the coming weeks and months, because the Moon is going to be making critical geometry to both outer planets, and the time between that critical geometry will be shorter and shorter until it peaks in July. I already mentioned that in previous updates, it is going to be critical. Here we see that there will be semi-right angles between the Moon and these outer planets, and on the 11th this happened, and then on the 13th, that is already within 2 days, and then again on the 14th and 16th, that will be right angles, and it is going to be critical. The closer these angles occur, until they occur at the same time, then it will be very, very critical. And then we could see major seismic activity as a result. So this lunar geometry is something to keep in mind in the coming weeks and months, and I will keep emphasizing this. But first, let's have a look at the convergence of planetary conjunctions tomorrow, what that is going to do. I expect a seismic increase. Whether or not it's going to reach magnitude 7, that is the question, because that depends on the stress levels in Earth's crust. We didn't have really atmospheric fluctuations in the last few days, so we look at the fluctuations on the 6th and the 7th, and I already mentioned those fluctuations. They marked the East Pacific regions, the Americas, and also the Red Islands, Aleutian Islands, and to the south, that is the Loyalty Islands region and New Zealand. And there have been some stronger earthquakes, magnitude 5.7, 5.8 even in these regions. And then also on the 7th, we had fluctuations in the Middle East, of Africa, and south of Africa. And we did have a magnitude 5 earthquake in South Africa. So not sure if these fluctuations are still relevant, but I'm showing them to you because they are the most relevant and strongest fluctuations that we had in recent days. These fluctuations, they are not perfect, but they can be a significant indicator. So we could see stronger seismic activity in the East Pacific regions. If we count about 6 days, we would end up around 13th, 14th. So let's see what is going to happen in the coming days. Be on watch. We can have very strong to major seismic activity following the convergence of planetary conjunctions tomorrow. Always check out the website for the latest updates, and we will add atmospheric fluctuations there as well. Stay safe. Until next time.